Miss Taylor?
Mr. Malado, come to take a dance lesson.
Miss Taylor?
Mrs. Taylor?
The rent on your studio is due.
Mr. Malado, you will receive your payment due when I have received my payment due from my students.
Yeah, Mrs. Taylor, you have no students.
And isn't it a sorrowful example of our times, Mr. Malado, that the young people of Indianapolis no longer share the enthusiasm of our generation for social dance? This is a tragedy for all of us that today's youth, instead of learning the delicate and graceful manners of etiquette and movement, have now fallen prey to the seamy vulgarities of ragtime music and alcoholic beverages, which, I have noted, alcoholic beverages you partake in on occasion, Mr. Malado. A sip. But still, it can, Mr. Malado. It can affect your judgment and temperament, if not, and heaven forbid that Mrs. Malado should ever learn of it.
Miss Taylor!
Mrs. Taylor. I was married once, but my husband died early in our marriage. He never drank, and I do believe that is what killed him.
Your rent must be paid within the week, or you'll be evicted, eh?
A week?
A week!
There is greatness in me, it shall be revealed. I have greatness in me, it can't be concealed. I shall provoke a world sensation, break down more doors than carry nation. The hyperloy will all agree, there is greatness in me. Mrs. Gumstock, how lovely to receive you. Have you come for your hygienics lesson?
Mrs. Taylor, the rent on your studio is overdue.
Yes, Mrs. Gumstock, and I will pay you all of which you are owed as soon as I am paid all of which I am owed by my students.
Mrs. Taylor, you have no...
No students. And isn't that a terrible reflection on our lovely community of Sandusky? A terrible reflection on the state of female hygienics and fitness that women cannot, no, will not take the necessary time and energy to concern themselves with a proper physical program. We are becoming a nation of bovine creatures, Mrs. Gumstock. Overfed, cud-chewing bovine creatures slouching our way to the slaughterhouse. Why, when I was studying in New Haven for my teaching degree in physical education, all I did was exercise. Exercise! Men appreciate that. Even at my age, men appreciate me, and I intend to keep it that way. And may I also compliment you on the appreciative glances you have been receiving of late from that handsome Mr. Colby. He's a man's man, un homme des hommes, with a discerning eye and a hearty, manly handshake, a grip. No wonder other men are jealous of him. Your dear old Mr. Gumstock must be too. Oh, he must be, for Mr. Colby is a fine specimen.
Mrs. Taylor, pay your rent, or I and Mr. Colby, Mr. Gumstock, will have to make you leave.
A week?
No, by Friday.
Friday?
There is greatness in me, woe to he who doubt. There is greatness in me, time will bear it out. I may not look like Lillian Russell, but I can still fill out a bustle. Why is it thus no one can see? There is greatness.
Edson Taylor! I have a claim brought against you in the amount of $122.03 that you are hereby ordered to pay in full or surrender the premises upon which you conduct your...
Music lessons, Mr...
Officer, darling.
Officer, darling. Yes, I teach classes in musical education, but not standard practice by any means. I teach a revolutionary new system of learning music that is a sensation. Through a system of massage and muscle manipulation... Here, sit... Through this system, massage and manipulate, massage and manipulate. Anyone can learn. The portals are opened and the joys of music are no longer consigned to the ecclesiastic gatekeepers, but now can be shared by the masses, even you, officer darling. Alas, no one here in Bay City, sad little non-revolutionary Bay City, is eager to try the new, to dare to venture. No, not here. No one dares to be transported, and that's what music does, officer darling. It transports. We can literally traverse time and place. Do you travel? I myself have traveled to the Florida Straits, sailed to Cuba during a hurricane, journeyed by rail to the wilds of Texas where armed robbers held up the train and demanded money from me, $800 concealed in my undergarments. But I said, no, blow away. I'd rather lose my brains than have no money, and they let me keep it. And thus you find me, a penniless, aging, 52-year-old school teacher who cannot teach because no one wishes to learn. Thus you find me, a widow. My husband was a Civil War veteran, many years older than I. Taller, too, but very kind in spite of his propensity to enjoy certain spirits. And yet, officer darling, darling, officer darling, it's with a sense of wonderment I speak this, for did you know I am a psychic? I am a psychic. I see things. I am a medium. I mediate between the then and now, the past and the future, and I can see in my mind's eye. The idea is manifesting itself carefully in my tired, old, widowed, 54-year-old woman's head. Perhaps, though I thought my music had abandoned me, perhaps, look, my hand is trembling. Perhaps, perhaps, officer darling, music has brought you to me!
I'd get out of town if I were you, ma'am.
But I have no money, no property. What would you have me do? Prostitute myself on the streets of Bay City? Would you see me used and misused for some nominal fee by wanton and lustful men who would have my body be the dump for their carnal and lascivious desires? Put that thought out of your head right now, officer darling.
I'm trying to, ma'am.
I have a sister in Auburn, New York. I suppose I could throw myself at her doorstep and beg for mercy.
I'd get out of town tonight, ma'am.
Tonight?
There is greatness in me, it would make you sob. Having greatness in me, it's a full-time job. Though my resources may stretch thinly, I could run circles round McKinley. I'm more electable than he. Like a man, she is labeled insane. If a woman dares to act like a man, she's a grief-inducing pain. But I am not a suffragette. I'm a woman through and through, and yet this woman, if she's called upon to fight, will fight for her on a honorable right to the greatness in me, which I must protect. I have greatness in me. I am God's elect. I am a work of bold ambition. I am my own world's exposition. I am not an easy thing to be. I will tempt my fate.
You owe us, Mrs. Taylor.
Watch me and you wait.
Get out of town.